I'm sitting with the OSINT Dojo, and in this video, we're going to cover how to chain along multiple Python collection tools into a simple bash script. These scripts are a great way to save time by automating the use of multiple tools against the same data point, rather than running each of these tools individually. We're going to cover some basic concepts and put together a sample script that takes a username as input, runs that username against three search queries, and then adds the results to a text file. On my screen here, I have multiple terminal windows where I previously ran different OSINT collection tools using my username as an example. In this terminal window, we have the results of the What's My Name search that shows what platforms also contain profiles under the same username. The next two terminals show the results of two Hollehi searches, one with gmail.com added to the end of my username, and the other one using protonmail.com. We're going to take these three searches and combine them into one script that we can execute anytime we want to perform the same searches on a target username. Let's go ahead and open up a text document as well as a new terminal window so we can start building and testing this new script. This will be a bash script, so let's go ahead and add this line here at the top to indicate that. Next, we will need to give some sort of prompt to the user so they know what they're supposed to do once this script executes. To do this, we're going to use the echo command and type out a prompt instructing them to provide a username before hitting enter. Let's save that and run the script from our new terminal window. To run the script, we're going to type dot forward slash and then our file name. We do get an error here, because we've not yet provided the proper execution permissions for the new file after we created it. We can add those permissions to the file by typing chmod plus x and then the file name. We can then hit the up arrow to go up to our previous commands. If we attempt to execute this file a second time, it does run, and we can now confirm that it displays the message that we provided. Next, we need to provide a way to save the user's input to a variable that we can then reference later. To do this, we're going to use the read command and then the name of our variable. Since we're asking the user to input a username for the script, we're going to use that as the name for our variable here as well. Running the script, we still can't quite tell if the input was saved to our variable because we aren't actually displaying anything yet. Let's add a temporary echo command to ensure that the data is being passed successfully. To make sure our script prints the input assigned to our variable and not just the word username, we need to make sure we include a dollar sign in front of it. Running the script once more, we can actually confirm that the data provided by the user is indeed being saved to the username variable. We need to take the three separate lines from our other terminal windows and transfer them into our new script. Let's take the first one for the What's My Name search to start. The general syntax is going to stay mostly the same, but we do need to make a couple tweaks. The first thing we need to do is remove the hard-coded username provided in our initial script. Instead, we need to replace that with our username variable, which captures the user's input. Next thing I want to do is, rather than send the output to the terminal, I want it to be saved to a text file. I can do that by adding two right arrows to the end of our line, and then putting in the location of the text file. We'll be using the username variable to generate the name of this text file. When using two right arrows, if you run the script again, it doesn't override the initial data in your text file. Instead, it simply appends the results of the new run to the end of the file. If you do happen to want to overwrite the file for each run, you can use a single right arrow here instead. Finally, let's add another echo command before the What's My Name line, so the user knows what's going on in the background. Let's save and run the script once more. This time, we don't see any output in the terminal because we instead saved it to a text file. After running the script, there's now a new text file created in our folder here. If we open it up, we can see the results of the What's My Name username search that is typically displayed within our terminal. Let's close this and delete the file before we do our other two searches. Since the terminal displays no message when the data is written to our text file, Let's add a new echo command for that as well. We're going to follow the same procedure as we did with the first search, including the echo commands, as well as replacing the hard-coded username with our username variable. I want all of the results appended to the same file, so I'm just going to copy that section from our first search and add it to the end of our other two. Since the last two searches are so similar, we're just going to copy this section and then swap out Gmail to ProtonMail. If we save this and run it one final time, we can see that all of the results are now within our text file. Using only a few quick lines of code, we've successfully combined these three different searches into a simple script that we can use again and again, rather than running them individually every time. These basics should be enough to get you started on building your own bash scripts, but keep in mind that we're only scratching the surface of what is possible.